Preventing psychological disorders in children, proper nutritional intervention to prevent problems of malnutrition, prevention of accidents in children, including poisoning, and the last point in the preventive pediatrics is screening tests and early interference methods for genetic and congenital diseases. That is screening for congenital and genetic disorders. Methylene, screening for congenital disorders, one of the tasks is prenatal ultrasound examination of the fetus. They may detect congenital heart disease. They may detect severe renal disorders that may affect the life of the fetus. Genetic screening is usually done by specific genetic testing. This is one of the diseases that may be covered by the preventive pediatrics. It can be detected very early in the pregnancy. اللي هي هذه Down syndrome واللي نعني بي 21 trisomy disease. It can be detected very early in conception. And you can deal with the fetus before survival. Abortion is one of the option. And following the fetus, إذا تأخرنا عن هذا الموعد to detect the possible congenital disorders that may accompany such diseases. The second scope is developmental pediatrics to study and solve problems about growth and development of children for a healthy childhood. It deals with healthy and ill children, not only the diseased ones. Observation of the normal physical and psychological growth and development of the child, and studying factors that affect the growth and development. Clinical pediatrics, according to the organ system. There is pediatric cardiology, respiratory medicine, pediatric hematology, nephrology, neurology, endocrinology, etc. There is also pediatric genetics, emergency medicine, and infectious medicine. So there are many subspecialties in pediatrics. How is pediatrics different from other medical fields? The characteristics of children, they have gradual growth of tissues and organs. They go through development of psychological characteristics. Differences exist among individuals, and genetic and congenital diseases are commonly found. Definitely, congenital disorders, they present early in life. فلهذا, pediatrics is more concerned with congenital disorders and genetic disorders more than the adult medicine. Environmental influences are common. The child is liable for the environmental risk factors more than the adult. The child is also more liable to acquire infections and communicable diseases. And prevention occupy one of the most important positions. Because the child is liable for infection, he is liable for traumas and accidents. It is definitely much more prevalent in the pediatric age group than in the adulthood. So the child is not a miniature of adult. يعني هو مو مجرد adult حجمه صغير. The principle of adult medicine cannot be directly adapted to children because the children, they have a unique biology, distinct risk factors اللي هي مرينا على البعض منها. Clinical manifestations of diseases also may be different in a child than in an adult. Many diseases are unique to children, خصوصا congenital disorders. Usually they present early in life and many of them, if they are not properly treated, the child may not survive and reach adulthood. Changes in body proportions from fetus to adults, حسب هذا المخطط اللي دا تشوفوه. The child metabolism is different. It is faster in childhood. ف فلهذا drug doses are usually higher. وهذه نقصد بها شباب the dose per kg per weight is higher. مو معنى total dose is higher. لما الأدلت البادي ويت مالته مثلا 70 or 75 definitely total dose راح تكون أعلى. بس إذا نحسبها dose per kg لا in a child it is higher. The fluid calorie intake is higher. Again هذه اللي نقصد بها per kg per kilogram body weight. The fluid requirement and the energy requirement is higher in childhood than in adulthood. Some physical parameters including the heart rate, the respiratory rate, they are higher early in life than during adulthood. مثلا بالfirst year of life, the average heart rate is 120 and during adulthood, as you know, المين مالتها هي 70 per minute. While the blood pressure is lower early in life. There is a higher proportion of body water. يعني the percentage of body water from the total body weight is higher in early in life. This is why children are more liable for problems of dehydration more than in adulthood. The child response to disease treatment is different, definitely. Now we are going to discuss the different age groups during childhood, لأنه هذه إلها nomenclatures. Definitely growth is a continuous process. ولو إحنا راح نقسمهم إلى age groups, بس there is a continuity between these groups. The grouping have relied on anatomical characteristics, physiological characteristics, and even psychological ones. فالمين groups هي الفيتس, the infant, the toddler, the preschool child, the school-aged child, and the adolescent. The fetal period is the period from the formation of the embryo until the birth of the fetus. يعني the whole pregnancy period. So the fetal life is divided into three trimesters. The first trimester اللي هو من from the time of conception until 12 weeks of gestation. This is named as the embryonic period. The middle or the second trimester from week 13 until week 28 it is the middle fetal life. The third or the late trimester is from week 29 until 40, which is the later fetal life. So what about the characteristics of each period? The first trimester of pregnancy, as we mentioned, are the first 12 weeks of gestation. It is very important for the development of the fetus and organogenesis, yani a formation of organ systems, cardiovascular, renal, GIT, etc. This is why infections, radiations, chemotherapy, or genetic problems may give rise to congenital malformation of organs. يعني any stressful condition, any risk factor affecting the mother during this period may end in congenital malformations of any of the organ systems of the fetus. The second trimester from week 13 to 28, by the 28th week of gestation, the body weight of the fetus is usually about 1 kilogram, 1 kg. هذه demonstration لل 28th week fetus, هذا he was born prematurely. ده تشوفون الarm مالته أصغر من ال circumference مال الرنج, من المحبس مال الفادر. The third trimester of pregnancy from week 29 until 40 week of gestation. During this period, the weight triples. احنا قلنا ال weight كان 1 kilogram at the end of the second trimester. It triples at the end of the third trimester. يعني المين راح يكون 3 كيلوغرامز. And the body length doubles as body stores of protein, fat, iron, and calcium increases. So the third trimester involves the storage of the main nutrients in the fetal body. This is why the more the baby is delivered prematurely, the more he is liable to suffer from nutritional deficiencies, because the last trimester is the time for deposition of nutrients in the fetal body. During the last trimester, the baby may suffer from intrauterine growth retardation if there are certain risk factors in the mother. Another problem may be faced of spontaneous abortion, premature delivery, or a low birth weight baby. As you know, the normal birth weight in the baby ranges between 2.5 to 3.5 kilograms. For anything below 2.5 kilogram at birth, we call it a low birth weight baby. Perinatal mortality is influenced by prenatal, maternal, and fetal conditions and by circumstances surrounding the delivery. At the end of the lecture, inshallah, يبقى لنا وقت ونعرف شنو, what do we mean by perinatal mortality. Diseases associated with preterm birth, low birth weight, and intrauterine growth retardation are many. Some of them are placental insufficiency, which predisposes the fetus to asphyxia, severe congenital anomalies in the fetus, and overwhelming early onset neonatal infections. هذه الفاكتورز كلها, it may end in premature delivery of the baby, or a low birth weight baby, or intrauterine growth retardation. إذا أنا دا أحكي بسرعة ما مفهومة, فأي أحد من عندكم ممكن يفتح المايك مالته وممكن يسوي كومنت at any time. بس لأنه إحنا هذه الحقيقة المانوفر مع البرزنتيشن لأول مرة يتطبق, وإحنا ملزمين بساعة أنه لازم ننجز المادة مالتنا, فلهذا نحاول نمشي بفترة معين. فإذا الفيرست period in the human life was the fetal life. The second period هو neonatal period, which is defined from the tying of the umbilical cord, يعني soon after delivery, until 28 days of life. So it is mainly the first 4 weeks of life. What are the features of this period? It is the beginning of independent life. Fetal life, he was relying on the maternal help, meaning placental perfusion. Now it is the beginning of the independent life. He should start breathing. He should start feeding to provide enough energy for his maintenance. Physiological regulation and adaptation to the circumstances are usually poor. Morbidity and mortality are very high during this period. What sort of care does the newborn baby needs? By the way, احنا من نقول newborn نقصد again the first 40 weeks of life. نقول neonate, هذه مرادفات. Synonyms, neonate and newborn, it means the first 4 weeks of life. So what care does the neonate needs? He needs enough nutrition, لأن قلنا صار independent, proper nursing care from temperature maintenance and prevention of cold injury and undue heat exposure. Proper nursing, it means also keeping him in a clean environment and avoiding infection and contamination, and prevention of diseases, because his immunity is limited. He is liable to acquire infections from his surroundings. فالنيونيتال period كانت the first 4 weeks. Next would be the infancy period. هذا ال period it harbors the neonatal period in with it, but it extends until the end of the first year of life. فلهذا it starts from birth till the end of the first year of life. So what about it? Here the baby grows most rapidly. يعني the speed of growth is highest during the first year of life. سرعة النمو هي highest in the first year of life. مو بمعنى انه البيبي body weight والهايت والكذا راح تكون اعلى من ما هو عمره 5 سنين. لا، هذه سرعة النمو، معدل سرعة النمو هي the highest in the first year of life. So the baby weight increases 3 times more than the birth weight. فاحنا قلنا ال birth weight المين مالته راح يكون 3 كيلوغرامز. ف at the end of the first year at least لازم يكون triple ال body weight. The length increases 1.5 times compared with the birth length. ال birth length عادة يجي 50 سنتيمتر. So at the end of the first year of life at least يكون 75. Every organ system continues developing and completing its maturation. فالorgan formation قلنا بدأ بالfirst trimester. It continues to grow even during the first year of life. There is a high daily demand for energy and protein. فas we have mentioned, we mean that energy calorie per kilogram body weight requirement is much higher than later in life. بس كتوتال caloric requirement definitely هذا الويت مالته إذا 3 كيلوغرامز حتى إذا أنطي per kg high التوتال راح يكون أقل من اللي وزنه 70 كيلوغرام. بس per kg per unit of body weight ال requirement of energy and protein is much higher than later in life. Gastrointestinal function is not completely developed. لأن إحنا قلنا الgrowth راح يستمر. Expected problems that may affect the child during the first year of life is rickets, anemia due to iron deficiency, malnutrition in general, whether due to energy or due to protein deficiency, and infections, including mainly diarrheal diseases. During this period, the maternal immunity gradually disappears. We mean by it, that is the passively transmitted maternal immunity through the umbilical cord to the fetus. The mother may transmit different immunoglobulins. So this sort of immunity gradually wanes and fades down during the first year of life. But autoimmunity, يعني the baby's own immunity, is still not mature. So this is why he is regarded as immune deficient, because the passively transmitted immunity from the mother is waning gradually, while his own immunity is not well developed yet. احنا قلنا لأن كل هاي procedures, it continues to grow gradually. So the features of this period is rapid growth, fastest brain growth. This means any insult that may affect the baby's brain during this period will leave a more severe damage than if it is done later in life. يعني مثلا تعرض CVA, ischemic injury to the brain. It affects the brain and leaving probably permanent deficit much more than if it affects him at the age of 5 or 6 years. Nutrition and energy requirement are high. Digestion and absorption is poor. Passive immunity gradually drops. يعني نقصد maternal passive immunity gradually drops. What sort of care does he need? He needs enough nutrition, prevention of diseases, and basic immunity. ال fourth period هسه راح يكون هو ال toddlerhood أو ال toddler age, which is the period from 1 to 3 years of life. Growth and development are slower. هسه احنا قلنا ال speed يعني السرعة راح تبدي تتناقص. بس هو بالنتيجة راح يستمر increasing his weight and height and other body measurements. There is rapid development in language and thoughts and ability to respond to people and objects. So there is rapid development of intelligence during this period. هنا أنا راح يصير more liable for accidental injury لأن he starts moving around. Road traffic injury are possible and poisoning. لأنه بدأ يتحرك so he can reach for different objects including poisons. What care does he need? Nutrition, disease prevention, and prevention of accidents. The preschool age from 3 years up to 6 to 7 years of age, اللي هو the age of school entry. The features of this period, growth becomes even slower, يتباطى أكثر بس يستمر هو بالنمو definitely. More mature intelligence, there is a strong desire for knowledge, imitating the adult's behavior. There is poor ability to identify damage. Here, the character of the child starts to be formed. تكوين الشخصية. What sort of care do they need? Enough nutrition, prevention of diseases and accidents, good habit training. هنا أنا بهذا البيريد ممكن نعلم البيسكس مثلا of behavior, of cleanliness, of toilet training, etc. The school age is the period from 6 to 7 years to the starting of adolescent phase, which is between 10 years in females and 12 years for boys. By the way, شباب, كل اللي داخلين رجاء يسجلون أسماءهم بالشات ليست. كل اللي دخلوا يسجلون أسماءهم بالشات ليست رجاء. So, then the school age children is between 6 to 12. The features is growth becomes relatively steady. I mean, it is continuing, but the speed مالته steady. ما بها تزايد هسه. More mature intelligence develops, increasing desire for knowledge, decreasing incidence of diseases. لأنه he starts recognizing how to protect himself. What sort of care do they need? Enough nutrition, prevention of eye and dental problems, prevention of problems in psyche, and emotional and behavioral training. The adolescence in females starts at the age of 10 to 11 until 17 to 18 years. In boys, it starts at 12 to 13 until 18 to 20 years. The second, here occurs the second peak of growth after infancy. يعني نعني, during this period, the speed of growth also increases in comparison to the previous periods, nearly similar to the infancy period. فأسرع فترة للنمو هي the infancy period, ومن ثم the adolescence period. هناهم راح تصير عندنا peak of growth. يبدي تسارع بالنمو. فمن هاي الليست يا شباب, you can recognize if I ask you to define the pediatric age group, هي until 18 to 20 years of life, actually. The British school, it will, the pediatric age group, the childhood period ends at the age of 18, while the Americans extend this period until the age of 20. For until 20, they may be called as children. So during adolescence, secondary sexual characters appear until they fulfill the sexual maturity, and then the growth stops. A period have been defined. What are the features of this period? The second fastest period of growth and development is during adolescence. There are neuroendocrine regulation, which is unsteady. بمعنى, they may have problems in psychology, in emotions, and behavior. the healthcare, enough nutrition, and good education. Okay. So there are some definitions that you need to be aware about. One of them is infant mortality rate. We mean by it is the number of deaths under the age of 1 year per 1,000 live birth. بمعنى هنا ما راح يحسبون الابورشنز من ضمن هذول الالف. ف death during the first year of life out of each 1,000 live birth. هذا اسمه الانفنت مورتاليتي ريت. Another definition is neonatal mortality rate, which means the number of deaths under the age of 28 days per 1,000 live births. The other term is early neonatal mortality rate, which is defined as the number of deaths under the age of 7 days per 1,000 live births. This diagram, definitely it is not for memorization. You need to have a look at it. فهنا عندنا neonatal death وهنا عندنا mortality rate in under 5 years of age children. تلاحظون هذه mortality in under 5 years of age, again per 1,000 of live birth. وهنا عندنا neonatal death يعني المورتاليتي اللي تصير بالفيرست 4 weeks of life. ف in children under 5 years of age بمعنى هنا راح يكون من ضمنها neonatal mortality هي. فالmost frequent cause of death is pneumonia 12.8%. Others high multiple diseases undefined. But next to it, من defined illnesses هي diarrhea, which forms about 8.6%. Later on, congenital anomalies, 3.5%, meningitis, 1.5%, malaria, 5.2%, and measles, 1.2%. So pneumonia, diarrhea, multiple causes, congenital anomalies, and various infections, including malaria, measles, meningitis, and birth-related problems. إذا نتحول للneonatal mortality, الmajor cause اللي هنا موجود بيها هو prematurity. It forms 15.9%. Followed by intrapartum related events, يعني birth injury, birth asphyxia. We mean by asphyxia is low oxygen supplement to the baby's brain, and sepsis or meningitis. So the major cause in the neonatal mortality is prematurity, followed by birth problems. هذا اللي يهمنا نعرفها. While in under 5 years of age as a whole, mainly here pneumonia, diarrhea, congenital anomalies, and a long list of infections. So, of the recommended survival strategies for children to reduce the mortality rate in childhood period is early breastfeeding. لأنه is going to protect him from many of the long list of infections اللي احنا استعرضناها pneumonia, diarrhea, other forms of infections. Exclusive breastfeeding. Exclusive breastfeeding again would prevent a long list of infections. Appropriate weaning. We mean by weaning. Weaning هو شباب مصطلح يستخدم لغرضين. واحدة منها it means weaning يعني stopping milk feedings whether breastfeeding or artificial feeding, or it is used more frequently here during our pediatric sessions when the baby starts adding solid food in addition to his milk, whichever type of milk. فهذه نسميه starting weaning food. احنا ما نقصد وقف الميلك انجستشن الميلك فيدينج، بس نقصد ضاف لها السوليد فودز. فابروبريت ويننج يعني ابروبريت سيلكشن اوف ويتش فود ايتمز تو اد تو ذا تشايلد اند ذا ابروبريت كليننج اند ستيريلايزيشن اوف ساتش فود. فاكسينيشن از ا فيري امبورتنت survival strategy in childhood because it prevents long lists of diseases and infections. Antenatal, intrapartum, and neonatal care, لأنه شفنا هذه بتاخذ حيز ليس بالقليل من المورتاليتي of children under 5 years of age. And specific case management of pneumonia and diarrhea, لأن هي the two major causes of death in under 5 years. So we need proper management for these problems. So we are through with the talk of today's lecture.